Good morning, dear students. So today we are going to read the poem Animals by Walt Whitman. Walt Whitman is an exponential American poet who also was very close to nature. He deviated from the traditional way of writing poem and he became the exponent of free verse. Earlier, traditionally, the poets used to have a metric system in the poem, and they used to have a rhyme and rhythm by using the rhyming words in the poem. But he deviated from the traditional way of writing poem. So Walt Whitman is therefore considered to be an American poet who the poet has brought about a picture of realism of the society, and he is the mediator of transcendentalism and realism of his times. So Walt Whitman's poem Animals is taken from his collection of poetry, that is Leaves of Grass. Songs of Myself. Now, Songs of Myself is the collection of again many poems which is incorporated in or included in the Leaves of Grass. In this poem, we are going to study the difference or the contrast between human beings and animals as observed by the poet. Now children, let me know, how many of you are animal lovers? Are you animal lovers? Do you find or observe something good in all the animals? How many of you have been to the zoo and admired the animals? They are poor such things who entertain us in circus, who give us a sense of pleasure in the zoo when we go and see them. And they are so selfless kind of beings, living beings, who are very close to human beings, and they are so lovable. Now sometimes children, you know, we say sometimes, don't behave like an animal, janvaro ki tarah mat behave karo. This is a very, very wrong way of accusing human beings. Human beings stand nowhere in front of the animals. There is no comparison between the animals and human beings. Sometimes, you know, we shout at people and we say, janvar ho gaye ho kya? Janvar ho ki tarah behave karte ho? लेकिन ये बिल्कुल जब आप ये पोएम पढ़ेंगे, व्हेन यू रीड दिस पोएम यू विल रियली फील दैट दिस काइंड ऑफ कंपैरिजन और दिस काइंड ऑफ एक्यूजेशन इज एब्सोल्युटली यूजलेस, बिकॉज द पोएट फील्स दैट ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आर नॉट एट ऑल अप टू दैट स्टैंडर्ड which the animals are. He feels that the animals are better than the human beings. And why this feeling crept up in his mind? This feeling, this observation came into his mind when he saw the people who were lusty, greedy, jealousy, and full of unkind behavior towards other human beings in the society. And furthermore, the poet has a wish to live in the animal world and live with animals rather than human beings who are so vile and a vicious kind of a circle of people living together. They have a sense of competitiveness. They have a sense of domination over each other. And these kind of feelings and greed leads the men to live a life of discontentment and unhappiness. So let us read the poem, and please follow the video. So dear students, you can see that we are going to read this poem, Animals, by Walt Whitman, who was an American poet. Let us know about the poet. Walt Whitman, an American poet, is a major figure in early American poetry. He broke the tradition of rhymed and metrical poetry. Rhyme, that is, the traditional form of poetry was to write rhymes and use rhyming words, and there was a proper metrical system deployed by the poets. But Walt Whitman was the first poet who broke that tradition, that traditional way of writing poetry. He was famous for writing a revolutionary new kind of poetry, which was in free verse. Now, free verse means where there are no rhyming words, where there are no limitations to the number of words in a particular line, and the one line could be continued, one thought could be continued into two or three lines, or one line, maybe just two words could make one line of the poem. The poem Animals is from his work Song of Myself in Leaves of Grass. Leaves of Grass is a book, is a collection of poems in which the poem Song of Myself is included. Leaves of Grass is a poetry collection by the American poet Walt Whitman. Although the first edition was published in 1855, Whitman spent most of his professional life writing and rewriting Leaves of Grass, revising it multiple times until his death. This resulted in vastly different editions over four decades. The first, a small book of 12 poems, and the last, a compilation of over 400. Now, talking about Song of Myself, this is yet another collection of poems which is incorporated in the book Leaves of Grass. Song of Myself might be the most egotistical poem ever written. It's all about me, myself, and I. So as the title of the poem itself tells you, that it is Song of Myself, that is poem written on his own self. In the first line, American poet Walt Whitman kindly informs us that he is going to celebrate himself. And throughout 52 glorious sections, he does just that. It takes guts to write a long epic poem about yourself. And Whitman was nothing if not gutsy. Gutsy, showing courage, or domination, or showing guts. This Song of Myself by Walt Whitman celebrates the theme of democracy and the oneness of mankind, specifically the American people. As well, it represents transcendentalist thought concerning mankind's common soul. The poem also focuses on the theme that life is a journey to uncover one's self and one's identity. Transcendentalists are those people, or the ideology of that particular group, who believed that nature too should be respected, and the relationship between nature and human beings. It was more about thinking that to give respect to the nature and to human beings. Whitman's poetry praises nature and the individual human's role in it. However, much like Emerson, Whitman does not diminish the role of mind or the spirit. Rather, he elevates the human form and the human mind, deeming both worthy of poetic praise. So, students, we'll see in this poem that how the poet was aware of the realism around him in the society, and he has also upgraded the human beings through inspiring them, and that is the Animals poem, which is the the exponential example of that idea. So before we begin the reading of the poem exactly, let us have an overview of the poem, or we can say the summary of the poem. In the poem Animals, the poet has described his will to become an animal because he thinks animals are far better than human beings. Human beings are greedy and full of jealousy against each other, but animals are calm and self-contained. The animals are happy with what they have. They never complain about miseries and sorrows. On the other hand, human beings complain about their miseries and sorrows. They give more importance to rich and strong people. They stay restless because of their wrongdoings and run behind the luxurious things of this world. Whereas animals are honest about their relations and don't give importance to a particular class. They live a life which is full of honesty and less of greed and jealousy. So in front of you now you can see the poem Animals written by Walt Whitman. The poet tells us that he feels more at home with animals than humans, whom he finds complicated and false. More at home. At home means peaceful, comfortable, happy. So he feels, the poet feels, that he is more comfortable with animals than with human beings, because the poet believed that human beings had a behavior and a temperament which was very complicated and fake, false. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. So, in this first two lines, the poet has said that he is thinking of changing. I think I could turn and live with animals. He wants to go and live with the animals in the animal world. He does not want to be in the society because, as I told you earlier, that he has projected the realism of the society where he had seen people are full of malicious feelings and ill feelings for their other human beings. And seeing this, the poet feels that he could turn. I think I could turn. Now look at the word could. Could means possible, whether if it is possible. If it is not possible, then how could it be? So he says that if it is possible, I think I could change and live with animals instead of the human beings. They are so placid and self-contained. So in this line, they refers to the animals. They are placid. Placid means very calm, and self-contained means contented, satisfied. I stand and look at them long and long. Why does he stand and look at them long and long? Because he observes them. The poet observes the animals for a long and long time and believes that they are absolutely different from human beings. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied. In these lines, the poet has said that they do not sweat and whine about their condition. Sweat means to complain, making efforts to keep on complaining. So, in the poem, they word refers to the animals. And the poet says that these animals do not sweat, that is, they do not waste time and energy in crying and complaining and whine about their condition, expressing their sorrows or crying about their condition. Their condition, whatever their condition is, whether they get the food, for that particular time or day or not, whether so they are happy with and satisfied with the condition whatever they are living in. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. That is, they are not restless and impatient, or they are not worried and full of anxiety. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. That is, unlike the human beings, the animals do not worry about anything or worry about their sins. Because the poet had observed that human beings, they are, if they commit sins, they weep for it, they keep on showing their anxiety, and they have sleepless nights. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. That is, he feels that other human beings in the society, what do? They show their religiousness and their faith in God just to make a show of it. They just pretend that they are very, very religious minded, and they show that they are very dutiful to God and sincere to God. But the thing is that whatever good they are doing in the society is just to highlight one's own self. And the poet feels that the animals do not make him sick, make him feel guilty about discussing their duty to God. They do not make a show of what their faith in God is, unlike the human beings in the society. Not one is dissatisfied. Dissatisfaction. Every animal in this world is very, very satisfied and contented with whatever their lot is, whatever their life is giving them. And on the other hand, the poet feels that the people in the society, the human beings in the society, are ready to crush one another by the way of their competition and by the major reason, that is dissatisfaction. Human beings are dissatisfied. They are not happy with what they are having. Their situation is absolutely unconvincing for them, because they want more and more. The more they get, the more they want. And this is the cause of dissatisfaction, which is totally absent in animals. Not one is demented with the mania of owning things. Not one. The poet feels that you cannot point out to any one animal which is mad for owning things. That is, typically the behavior of human beings. They want to have everything in their possession, and due to that jealousy of seeing others having many things, they also want to add up to whatever their possession is. And the poet feels that this quality is not there in the animals, and not a single animal is demented. Demented means mad with the mania. Mania is again madness of owning things. So this is how he feels that there is a drastic or a tremendous difference between human beings and animals. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Now, this is human worship. The poet has talked about the human worship. Or in the society, he had seen the rich people being glorified by the subjected ones, or the poor ones who were dominated by the rich people, or dominated by the people of the higher society. Not one kneels to another. Now here this line tells about the animals. In this, the poet has said that not a single animal glorifies any other. They do not kneel to another, nor to his kind. Kind, that is, another animal that had lived thousands of years ago. But we do it. Human beings do that. We glorify people or our ancestors who had lived thousands of years ago. And we are, the poor is subjected by the rich people, and the poor or the suppressed ones are supposed to glorify the others. So this kind of disparity in the society is not seen in the animal world. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So it's again the disparity, showing the difference between the people who are of same type. All the human beings are human beings. There is hardly any difference, but the difference is made on the basis of caste, creed, and their richness and their position. So the poet says that not one is respectable, that is, everybody enjoys the same prestige and dignity, everybody has his own self-respect, but the human beings are not so. Some people are more respectable and some have to face the suppression. They are looked down upon or unhappy over the whole earth. So these are the two contrasting pictures of the people in the society. Some people are highly glorified, respectable, enjoying a lot of dignity and good position in the society. And on the other hand, some who are suppressed are unhappy. So there is no equality in the society, you can say that. But in animal world, it's not so. Whether it's a small animal, it has its own respect. Whether it's a large animal, it has its own respect. Students, you must have visited zoo when you would have been small. Have you seen how the animals behave when they see the human beings? They are afraid of them. But have you ever seen them complaining or charging any other animal? No. So every animal seems to be enjoying its own food and enjoying its own life without meddling or interfering into the life of other people. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. Now this line shows the acceptance of the poet. The poet believes that the animals show their relations to me. That is, they are very much similar to the poet, because the poet feels that the qualities of the animals are somehow related to him and he accepts them. They bring me tokens of myself. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. The poet has beautifully described the qualities, the good qualities, the virtues of human beings, which the poet feels have been lost, are kept in the possession of animals. In simple words, what I wish to explain is that the poet feels that they bring him the tokens, the qualities, the virtues of myself. Myself stands here for the human beings. The human beings have lost their virtues, and where have they, who has found them? The animals have found them. They evince, the meaning of evince is to show, to reveal, to disclose. And they again, the animals, they disclose them plainly in their possession. And who has found those good qualities? The good qualities and the virtues are found by the animals, and they are plainly means in a simple manner. They do not boast about it. They are not proud about it, but they keep it in their possession. That means they are having more good qualities and virtues than human beings. Now, this line in the poem depicts the contrast between human beings and animals, which is actually the basis of the moral sense in human beings. The poet wants to say that the human beings who had these tokens or the qualities, good qualities, have lost them, and perhaps they call themselves more civilized by not having the good qualities in the society. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? A beautiful way of expressing this kind of loss of virtues. Walt Whitman, the poet, believes and he wonders, he's surprised where they get those tokens, from where these animals get these good qualities. And what are the good qualities? Good qualities are satisfaction, happiness, enjoyment, and having selfless behavior. They do not have jealousy. They are loving. And all these good qualities, the poet feels that, did I pass? Now that is a question. He is wondering, where have these animals found it? Maybe huge times ago, that is, in the past time, from the ancient times, the human beings have negligently dropped them. That is, negligently, carelessly, human beings lost all their good qualities they had passed that phase where they had the good qualities. So in a way, Walt Whitman, the poet, is referring to the civilization period. So when, before civilization, the human beings were just as animals. They did not have this feeling of competitiveness, jealousy, hatred. And as and when they started getting civilized, all these vices, V-I-C-E-S, V-I-C-E, vice means all the bad qualities. All the bad qualities started creeping into human beings' mind, and though they were modernizing, civilization and getting civilized, they stopped being good human beings. They had, in fact, as per the poet, they had dropped it carelessly somewhere, and the poet feels or wonders that perhaps the animals found those tokens or qualities somewhere there. So this is the meaning and explanation of the poem, and I will be giving you some questions, also one stanza for reference to context. Please do the assignment and compile them in proper notebooks, because we may be taking the notebooks for correction as and when we get the opportunity after this COVID-19. So the poem tells that it is not the glorification of animals or their qualities, but it is to make the human beings realize that how their greed and jealousy has landed them into sleepless nights, restlessness, and all these loss of humanity and qualities have put them into trouble. So this is the central theme of, or you can say the theme of the poem, and the central idea of the poem. Now the style of the poem is, you can see it is free verse or blank verse, where you can see that there are no rhyming words and no rhyming pattern. Now let us have a look at the literary devices, which is also known as figures of speech, used by the poet in the poem. He has used assonance, that is the use of vowel sounds, sound I, which is repeated and it is used in the line there. So it is assonance. Repetition is use of the word. So difference between assonance and repetition, you can see assonance is the use of vowel many times, and repetition is the use of the complete word. So the word long is used, long and long, twice, therefore it is repetition. Anaphora, again the same line, you can see that I word used at the start of two consecutive lines. Two consecutive lines means one after the other. When you use the beginning of the lines with the same word, it is anaphora. In yet another lines in the poem, you can see that there are two lines which begin with they do not. Again, there is anaphora, which is a use of repeated words at the beginning of two or more consecutive lines. So one after the other, then the lines are begun with they do not. So it is anaphora. Metaphor. Sweat and wine refer to the cries and complaints of human beings. Now, metaphor, may I remind you that in this figure of speech, there is a comparison made between two things, and the words like and as are not used. The poet does not use the word like, that sweat is like the complaints of human beings. So when the like word is missing, then it is metaphor. If the word like is used, then it is simile. Again, you can see that the literary device in the last lines, there is a metaphor used, that is the inner qualities of humans are referred to as tokens. So tokens are compared as with the qualities of human beings. So that's all with the literary devices. And now we will discuss the central idea of the poem. The central idea of the poem. In the poem Animals, the poet Walt Whitman praises animals for being better than human beings and for possessing all such qualities that humans lack or have forgotten. Those qualities are calmness, the lack of greed, and the ability to stay happy and contained, among others. The most important theme of the poem is not to praise how good animals are, but to compare humans with them in order to highlight the flaws of their nature. Flaws, their weaknesses, their ill feelings, their vices, their bad qualities. The poet believes that probably a very long time ago, humans possessed all these qualities mentioned above, but they have now lost them. So this is the theme of the poem, and we have seen the central idea of the poem, and I would now request you all to write down the central idea of the poem in your notebooks. Also, please attempt the questions given in the assignments. Thank you.